Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Uzma Jafri. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Friday, the 16th of July. India proposes inclusion of Iran's Chabahar port in INSTC framework. Afghan Vice President accuses Pakistan Air Force of supporting Taliban. And Pakistani minister Gandapur's convoy comes under attack in Pakistan-administered Kashmir. And now for all the details. India's Foreign Minister S. Jaishankar addressed the Central South Asia Conference in Uzbekistan on Friday and proposed to include Iran's Chabahar port in the International North-South Transport Corridor framework for unhindered access to the sea in the Central Asia region. In a veiled attack on Pakistan, he pointed to the various deficiencies in the connectivity plans professed by it.
India's Foreign Minister S. Jaishankar on Friday proposed to include Iran's Chabahar port in the International North-South Transport Corridor or INSTC framework for a secure, viable and unhindered access to the sea for Central Asian countries. Addressing the Central South Asia Conference 2021 in Uzbekistan, he also stressed on the liable connectivity within and through Afghanistan amid the ongoing conflict in the country. He said the world must have confidence in its governance. Without taking Pakistan's name, Jaishankar said blocking connectivity in practice while professing support in principle benefits no one.
For reliable connectivity within and through Afghanistan, the world must have confidence in its governance. Our connectivity deliberations expect predictability, efficiency, and observance of the norms of our times as its foundation.
The INSTC is a 7,200-kilometer-long multimode transport project for moving freight among India, Iran, Afghanistan, Armenia, Azerbaijan, Russia, Central Asia, and Europe. Jaishankar described the formation of the India-Uzbekistan-Iran-Afghanistan Quadrilateral Working Group on the joint use of Chabahar Port as a welcome development.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Friday urged states where COVID-19 cases are rising to take proactive measures to prevent a third wave. Modi said apprehensions about a third wave of the coronavirus are being expressed, with number of cases in some states a matter of concern. In a meeting with the chief ministers of six states, he said that officials need to ramp up the test, track, treat, vaccinate approach to tackle the rising COVID-19 cases.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Friday reviewed the COVID-19 situation with chief ministers of six states, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, Odisha, Kerala and Maharashtra, and urged them to take proactive measures to prevent a third wave. In the last 1 week, 80% of the total reported cases in India came from these states. 84% of the deaths in the past 1 week also came from these states. During the meeting, Prime Minister Modi expressed concern over the rising number of COVID-19 cases in some states and said that the officials need to ramp up the test, track, treat, vaccinate approach to tackle the rising cases.
Test, track, treat and tika. Isi vaccines ki hamari ranjiti focus karte hui hume aage badhna hai. Micro containment zones par hume विशेष ध्यान देना होगा जिन जिलों में पॉजिटिविटी रेट ज्यादा है जहां से नंबर ऑफ केसेस ज्यादा आ रहे हैं वहां उतना ही ज्यादा फोकस भी होना चाहिए
Reiterating his concern over unmasked tourists flocking to towns and cities, the Prime Minister said the administration must remind citizens that COVID-19 is not yet over. The meeting comes days after PM Modi took stock of the COVID-19 situation with chief ministers of northeastern states. Meanwhile, India reported on Friday 38,949 new coronavirus cases over the last 24 hours, health ministry data showed, taking the nationwide tally above 31 million.
Moving on, Indian security forces killed two terrorists belonging to Pakistan-based Lashkar-e-Taiba LAT outfit in Srinagar city of northern Jammu in Kashmir territory on Friday. The terrorists were local and were involved in three serious incidents involving the killing of two civilians, one policeman, and injuring several others with grenade attacks. They were also conducting a recruitment drive in the valley, police said. Both the terrorists belong to LAT as per police. Jammu and Kashmir is a Muslim majority region at the heart of decades of hostility between India and Pakistan. The neighbors both rule parts of the region while claiming the entire territory as theirs.
ये तीनों मॉडल इंसिडेंट में ये दोनों का हाथ था। हम लोग इसको ट्रैक कर रहे थे। जब कल कंफर्म हो गया इंफॉर्मेशन पिन पॉइंट, तो फिर सीआरपी पुलिस ने जाके उसको कोडन किया। कोडन करते ही अंदर से फर आया। फिर हम लोगों ने उनको बोले कि सेंडर कर जाओ, अपील किए, नहीं माना। फिर उसके बाद इनकाउंटर शुरू हो गया, जिस इनकाउंटर में दोनों मारे गए।
इन न्यूज फ्रॉम अफगानिस्तान, अफगानिस्तान वाइस प्रेसिडेंट अमरुल्ला साले ऑन थर्सडे अक्यूज्ड द पाकिस्तान एयरफोर्स ऑफ वार्निंग अफगान सिक्योरिटी फोर्सेस दैट इट वुड रिटेलिएट अगेंस्ट एनी मूव टू डिसलॉज तालिबान फाइटर्स इन अ स्ट्रेटेजिक बॉर्डर रीजन। The airstrike was aborted due to the Pakistan's warning, reports suggest. However, 20 Taliban insurgents were killed in another airstrike in Badakhshan province, Afghan Defense Ministry claimed.
Afghanistan's Vice President Amrullah Saleh on Thursday accused the Pakistan Air Force of warning Afghan security forces that it would retaliate against any move to dislodge Taliban fighters in the strategic border region of Spin Boldak. Taking to Twitter, Saleh blamed Pakistan Air Force is now providing close air support to Taliban in certain areas. As doubts were expressed about the accusation, in another tweet he said that he was ready to share evidence and also termed Pakistan's Foreign Ministry's denial as pre-written paragraph. The airstrike in Spin Boldak was aborted due to the warning, reports suggest. However, 20 Taliban insurgents were killed in airstrikes by Afghan forces in Badakhshan province on Thursday, the Afghan Defense Ministry claimed. Clashes between the Taliban and government forces have intensified as US-led international forces have been withdrawing. The Taliban have captured several districts and border crossings in the north and west. In the latest, U.S. Special Envoy Zalmay Khalilzad said on Friday that United States will support the Afghan government even after the completion of its military mission, and it will not recognize a Taliban government in Kabul taken by force.
A group of political activists hurled eggs and stones on the convoy of Pakistani Minister Ali Amin Gandapur in Pakistan-administered Kashmir on Thursday, triggering aerial firing from his guards, local media reported. This comes ahead of legislative assembly election in the illegally occupied region, which is slated for July 25.
A group of political activists said to be affiliated with Pakistan Muslim League Nawaz Party hurled eggs and stones on the convoy of Pakistani Federal Minister for Kashmir Affairs Ali Amin Gandapur in Pakistan-administered Kashmir on Thursday, triggering aerial firing from his guards, local media reported. A video was also posted by Gandapur's Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf party on Twitter with a note that the attack was instructed by Raja Farooq Haider, the Prime Minister of Pakistan-administered Kashmir, who can now see defeat after big PTI gatherings there. This comes as campaigning is on full swing in Pakistan-administered Kashmir for the Legislative Assembly election in the illegally occupied region, scheduled to take place on July 25, despite fears of coronavirus spread. Locals and activists have blamed all major political parties are engaged in pre-poll rigging. They have lamented that although Islamabad claims to have given autonomy to the region, the Legislative Assembly for which the election is to be held is not allowed to pass any legislation without its approval.
In news from Nepal, The authorities in Nepal's Kathmandu Valley has decided to continue the ongoing lockdown till July 25 to contain the COVID-19 pandemic, but with further relaxation in the provisions of the prohibitory orders. In recent weeks, authorities have been gradually easing the provisions of lockdown while extending it time and again.
Authorities in Nepal's Kathmandu Valley on Thursday extended the prohibitory orders in place since April 29 in three districts of the valley, Kathmandu, Lalitpur and Bhaktapur, by another 10 days from Friday to July 25 with no substantial changes. In a meeting of the valley's three chief district officers on Thursday, it was decided to extend the prohibitory orders, but no decision has been made regarding the long route transport services. Earlier, the authorities on July 6 had extended the prohibitory order for 10 days, removing the odd-even number plate rule for vehicles in the valley. Public gatherings remain banned, but examinations can be conducted with no more than 25 examinees per examination hall. Restaurant can provide takeaway services only until 7 p.m. local time. Public vehicles can carry passengers only to their seat capacities by following health protocols. Nepal has been gripped by a second wave of coronavirus since early April, and daily cases in the South Asian country have remained between 1,500 and 2,000 in most of the last few days. On Friday morning, Nepal reported 1,782 new cases and 33 more deaths, bringing the total cases to 662,570 and the death toll to 9,463.
Farmers in India's Jammu and Kashmir are generating good revenue from sale of cocoons in an auction organized by the Sericulture Department in the Union Territory. The farmers were earlier bearing losses as the markets were closed due to the COVID-19 pandemic.
Farmers practicing sericulture in India's Jammu and Kashmir are generating good revenue from the sale of cocoons at a retail market in Udhampur district, which has been organized by the Sericulture Development Department. The silk cocoon auction market held at Sericulture Complex in Udhampur commenced on July 7 and will conclude on July 25. So far, in 7 days, over 45,000 kilograms of cocoon has been auctioned. Hundreds of farmers, mostly women, have been participating in the auction. The farmers were bearing losses as the markets were closed due to the COVID-19 pandemic. The initiative is helping both farmers and buyers to sell and procure the produce directly.
हमें पहला आ गया लॉकडाउन की वजह से जो माल जो रहा ना बरसात में खराब हो जाता है ना इसलिए जल्दी इसका क्यों जो मंडी लगाई जाए हम इस बार तो रेट भी अच्छा है मंडी भी अच्छी लगी है और रेट भी अच्छा चल रहा है 900 साढ़े 900 हजार तक रेट जा रहा है
कितने खुश होते हैं
आप इसमें कि अच्छा रेट मिल जाता है तो अच्छा काम करते हैं हम
और हमारे टोटल जो फार्मर्स हैं वो 6,000 फार्मर्स हमारे साथ जुड़े हुए हैं आज तक हमारी मार्केट में 45,300 केजी क्रॉप आ गई है कोकोन्स की सेल हो गई है जिनकी कॉस्ट 1,38,00,000 रुपये बनती है
With an aim to make women self-dependent, central as well as the state government had launched many schemes for the upliftment of women in sericulture sector, and they have been also reaping benefits of these schemes and earning handsome money.
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude the top stories once again. India proposes inclusion of Iran's Chabahar port in INSTC framework. Afghan Vice President accuses Pakistan Air Force of supporting Taliban. And Pakistani Minister Gandapur's convoy comes under attack in Pakistan-administered Kashmir. Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter at @sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time next week. Have a great weekend. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.